بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Honorable Prime Minister Modi, Head of State, Ministers, Excellencies, Distinguished Delegates, Ladies and Gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum. It gives me a great pleasure to be addressing such an immediate gathering today in the vibrant land of Gujarat. Let me begin by thanking the state government for inviting the UAE as the partner country and applaud its effort for organizing a summit of such a global scale. It is our first time as a partner country, and we hope that this will be just the beginning and our association with Gujarat grows stronger with each passing year. As this year, we are participating with more than 50 delegates across various sectors. Gujarat, a land synonymous with culture, commerce, it has not only given the world some of the most exemplary and inspiring leaders of all time, such as the Mahatma Gandhi and Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, but is also the home state of India's visionary Prime Minister Modi and many successful Indian entrepreneurs and business families. India is an extremely important partner for us, and the historic ties between the UAE and India are witnessing a rapid and significant growth driven by the shared economic and strategic interests and close people-to-people contact. Ladies and gentlemen, at this stage, I think it would be fair to say UAE-India ties are stronger and more vibrant than they ever been. The UAE is the largest Arab investor country in India, accounting for more than 85% of total Arab investment in India. UAE is the 10th biggest investor in India. UAE's investment in India amount to more than $10 billion, including $4 billion in the form of DI. UAE's continued commitment toward investing in India's growth story can be testified by the fact that the UAE investment into India reached a historic jump of $1 billion only in the last year. Bilateral trade between the UAE has grown significantly from $180 million in the 1970s to more than $50 billion in the 2016. With immense growth potential, the UAE is India's third largest trade partner, while India stands as the UAE's largest trade partner. The visit of the Prime Minister Modi to the UAE in 2015 and the visit of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, Abu Dhabi Crown Prince and Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE to India last year have given a new impetus and re-energized our partnership that have been growing steadily over the years. On this occasion, I would like to take the moment to thank the Indian government for its kind gesture for inviting His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed as the chief guest for its Republic Day. The forthcoming of His Highness will be the second visit to India in less than a year. And this, I believe, speaks volume about the value that both countries place in our critically important relationship. Ladies and gentlemen, some of the most important prominent companies from the UAE have been very active in India and have a long history of association. For instance, Global Marine Terminal Operator, DP World, operates 5 key container terminals in India, including the Mundra Port in Gujarat, and have invested heavily to become the largest container terminal operator in the country. I am proud to add to that DP World supports more than 30% of India's container trade. The UAE hosts the largest Indian community overseas, with more than 2.6 million Indians living and working in the UAE. According to the World Bank statistics, their annual remittances are estimated to exceed $13 billion, a clear evidence of the ever-growing robust bilateral ties and vital mutual interests. Improved air connectivity is yet another important economic growth driver. It facilitates trade and tourism and has multiplier effect. The air connectivity between our two countries has also increased tremendously, with over 1,000 flights weekly between the UAE and India. Ladies and gentlemen, with landmark initiatives such as Make in India, Startup India, coupled with liberalized FDI policy regime and digitization, India is certainly becoming one of the most preferred investment destinations globally. The different states of India present immense investment diversity. And as part of our diversification strategy, we strive to explore newer avenues for investment and trade, and Gujarat is definitely in our radar. We firmly believe that there are synergies for cooperation between us and with the attractive investment climate here. I'm confident that the UAE business will be keen to explore new opportunities and cooperation in many areas such as renewable energy, petrochemicals, gems and jewelries, pharmaceutical, financial services will be of particular interest to us. Lastly, ladies and gentlemen, greater achievement call for even bigger changes. The changing global economic headwinds have driven countries to embrace innovative systems, better policies, and newer technologies across all sectors to facilitate dynamic growth. As we grow along our shared economic interests, we would be pleased to share our innovation-led growth models with India so that maximum mutual gains can be obtained. I wish this event all the success, and thank you very much.
Your barrel bombs and mortars and airstrikes have allowed the militia in Aleppo to encircle tens of thousands of civilians in your ever-tightening noose. It is your noose.